Clare, thank you so much for coming, and I want everyone to know that you drove here carrying 8 sewing machines in your vehicle. Because when you were here before, you taped some wonderful segments on using the presser feet that you designed and that are geared for wonderful things, and we'll be talking about that too. But I guess what everybody noticed was you had a sewing machine that wasn't white.
That's right.
Like the blue one we have here. How in the world did you have the courage to paint your sewing machine?
Well, it makes people understand that my creative feet fit all sewing machines if they can't tell what brand the sewing machine is.
Oh, I
see. That's what made me start painting them, and now I'm known for having a painted sewing machine, so if I don't have one, people don't think I'm me.
You're not you. And so people will know this machine, both baby
they're
locks,
the same
they're
thing.
Exactly
so
the
before
same.
Uh-huh. And the after.
After. Well, they are beautiful, but you're an artist. You've been painting for many, many years. But
yes.
You say that even those of us who aren't really artistic can do this. And
yes.
You have a new product called Stick and Rinse that's going to be very helpful, right?
That's right. It's a template that washes away, allowing people, even if you had an aneurysm, like my friend Terry, she actually painted her sewing machine as well using just sponges.
Wow.
And children uh-huh. all the way up to even children like us
uh-huh.
can paint anything.
Older children. Well, and we might as well say up front, because we don't have time to go through every step, but you have a
right.
great DVD that people can get, and that way they can play it, pause it, go back and paint their machine,
a
come back.
A lot safer to uh-huh. Learn from my mistakes
well,
than
that's,
to make your own.
Make your own. And machines are so expensive. I know people have asked you, why would you paint it?
Yeah, because things shouldn't be just plain white.
Well, we're anxious to learn how. And there are some safety features that you wanted to point out.
Yes, this is an electronic device. So, mm-hmm. And we're going to be using water.
So
you want to make sure that you unplug it from any electrical source.
Mm-hmm.
And then we're going to use different things like painter's tape.
Mm-hmm.
Painter's tape and masking tape are completely different. If you leave masking tape on something long enough, the adhesive will transfer onto the surface. So uh-huh. I always use artist tape.
Uh-huh.
Which you can use not just for covering areas like your throat plate.
So you're covering where water might get down in the bobbin.
Yes, and
case. Uh-huh.
And into electronic boards if you have a computerized machine like
oh,
this
yeah.
one.
Uh-huh.
But you can also use artist tape in different sizes and to
make stripes.
To make stripes.
Or designs.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
And then when you're done and the paint has completely dried, then you can peel it off, and it won't peel the paint up. That's the difference between artist tape and painter's tape when you go to the art supply store versus the paint store.
Okay. And one thing I guess everybody asks you, well, won't that design, whatever that design is that's painted on this part, won't that come off on your fabric when you're sewing?
It will if you just simply stick a sticker of our water soluble stabilizer printed onto your machine, and it can rub off. Like this is just an ink uh-huh. transfer, but on a color like this, you can see the butterfly was printed on the paper first, and then I taped the Stick and Rinse over it and print again. And now we have a sticker.
You sort of make your own tattoo.
Yes.
Uh-huh.
So you can apply that, but if you apply it here, it would be only applied on the surface of the machine if you're going to wipe it away. And we do that by using a simple Q-tip and water, and you wet the area that you want to paint.
Oh.
And you let it soak for a little while, then use an ordinary toothpick and mm-hmm. and then wipe it away using not your finger but a
paper
towel.
Uh-huh.
And now you have a clean surface, and now even if you have no paint brushes, you can use a Q-tip.
Paint with a Q-tip. Oh.
And just dab it on, or your finger if you want to be a little kid or have children around. And you can mix and make by just tapping, blend these together. And if you don't like what you did, since we're using acrylic paint,
it's a water-based paint.
You can uh-huh. wipe it away and try
and
again.
Start over.
And the nice thing about this is the stabilizer remains and is a template or protection against your sewing machine getting damaged.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, not that. It's a protection to keep the paint from going into the area you're
right.
not painting.
Even
it.
Though we could see that red still around the edge, it's not going to be on the sewing machine.
Right.
Uh-huh.
And then when we go to the next area, it's definitely easier with a paintbrush for me.
Mm-hmm.
So we use paintbrush, and you can just tab it. Now, when we want to go do this area, we'll remove it again and enter the next color.
Do you suggest just removing one area at a time?
Yes, that way you can be messy and go over an area and it won't actually be on the machine.
Sense.
Then you go to wet that area and wipe it away. And that's how anybody can paint using sponges, ordinary kitchen sponges as well can be used for that.
Let's see how you would do a stencil on top.
So another application would be to use stencils that are available in stores. This is a fun one. And you just, you should apply a spray adhesive to the back of the stencil. That way it will have an airtight hold on there. And then you can use some sponge and just go like this.
Dab it.
And the reason you want to make sure you use spray adhesive on the back is so it doesn't slip. And you see you have a little bit there. And you can also use sponges to create backgrounds.
Kind of that faux finish look people do on
And this seems scary, but remember this can just easily be wiped off. And now we're going to go ahead with one of my favorite colors here.
You like teal,
I do.
Blue, all colors.
I love blue.
And while you're doing that, you said we can paint with fingernail polish. We can paint with acrylics.
Yes, and always make sure that you refer to the DVD before you apply fingernail polish. That's a permanent bond.
Right.
And we also seal this. If you love it, you seal it. If you don't love it, like my niece Monica painted this machine, and in 5 years, she may not like it at all. She can wipe it completely clean and start over again.
Because this hasn't been sealed with...
Because it hasn't been sealed.
Something like
with
this.
With an artist
finish
sealant,
of some
as shown on the DVD.
Okay, that's good.
And if you can't paint, and you just got to have something on your machine, you can print out our sticker and peel it back. Simply stick it onto your machine. As long as it's not in the area where your fabric will be sewing. And then you have a tattoo on your sewing machine.
And then this peels off?
It'll peel off whenever you're ready to peel it off. Otherwise,
otherwise it stays on there.
You have a tattoo on your machine.
But we might show, this is the product, and this is kind of what it looks like when you run this through your printer.
It's clear first. You print on your paper first. That way you know where it's going to print. And this way you don't waste ink printing
or
waste the stabilizer by printing words. And then you'd apply after printing onto the machine. And that is how Monica painted the front of that machine.
Wow.
And so it is a relaxing, easy way to paint anything, including different items inside your house, like your mixers. And
you have a little spool stand that you use.
Yes, and this
sewing is
100% nail polish.
Oh, is it?
So you would use the sticker to help you print the flowers on there, and otherwise you can just kind of...
Freehand
it. And I don't use the paintbrush that comes in the nail polish bottle.
Oh, no, you probably use one of your others that's a better shade. So, gosh, I guess there's no limit to what all we can paint.
That's right.
What is it you said they say about you?
If it sits still long enough, it's going to get painted.
Well, I think this would be so much fun to watch the video, and then if you had a machine, and maybe we could start on something like this until we sort of felt more comfortable.
Yes, actually, I teach and recommend that you paint the case of your sewing machine first.
Oh, that's a good idea. Mm-hmm. In fact, that's what this is. This is
yes,
the case to this machine.
Yes, that is the
case. Great idea. Well, thank you so much for going to all the trouble and for showing us that we can do it too.
Oh, it's my pleasure.